This is Lynn Pollard. I'm a parent contributor to the National Center for Learning Disabilities, and today I'm going to talk about a topic that I'm really excited about, which is music. Talking about engaging your kids with learning differences and special needs in learning to play an instrument, learning to read music in a way that plays to their strengths rather than to their weaknesses. So first I'm going to start with a story. I'm going to give two different stories or scenarios today. One is about how I did something the wrong way, and the other is about how I figured out how to do it the right way. So I think it's always good to kind of, you know, learn from those lessons learned that other people have gone through. So first, I just want to mention that I was raised in a really musical household. My mom is a violin teacher. My grandmother was a violin teacher. And my mom got me engaged, my sister, with learning to play an instrument, violin, when we were really young. And so when my kids came along, I just automatically assumed that they would also be engaged with music, which they definitely are. But it's definitely been something that's been, you know, a little bit of a challenge, and we've had to deal with some challenges in a way that we didn't anticipate before we realized that we had kids with learning differences and special needs. So the first scenario was with my daughter. My daughter is dyslexic. And so basically with what happened with my daughter is that we had signed her up for a music camp. It's the kind of thing where the kids learn the music and the songs and the motions and everything. They have about a week of camp, and then at the end of the week, they do a big presentation for the families. Well, the first year that we have my daughter do this camp, we got the CD and the music CD, but we just kind of listened to it sporadically. We didn't really engage her with really trying to learn the lyrics ahead of time, and we kind of just threw her into camp and gave her the same amount of time that all the other kids had to learn the lyrics and the songs that week. Well, what we found was that that just did not work. At the presentation at the end of the camp, she didn't know the words, and it was really hard to watch her because we could tell that she knew the music and the sound of the music, and she knew the motions and different things like that, but she didn't have enough time to learn the lyrics. And so this past summer, the second summer that she did a similar camp, we made sure to get the CD. We got it about a month and a half ahead of time. We let her listen to it practically every day. I listened to it with her, and that way I could listen to her sing. If there was a word that she didn't understand or that she wasn't pronouncing appropriately, I would, you know, talk to her about it. And so by the time the camp got there, she already knew the songs and knew the lyrics. And so when she went into the camp and she was able to really focus on, you know, learning the motions and really getting into it. And so by the time the presentation came around, she was just totally prepared and had totally come up to speed, you know, with all the other kids. And so for that, the lesson learned is just that, you know, as you hear probably a lot, I know I hear a lot in my reading and learning, is that kids with dyslexia and adults as well just need extra time. And with my daughter in that case, she really just, that extra time of working with her to learn the lyrics was, you know, made all the difference for her at the performance. And so for my son, who is on the high functioning end of the autism spectrum, my little story of lesson learned with him is that, like I mentioned, you know, I got engaged with learning to play an instrument at a really young age. And so we enrolled my son in piano lessons when he was about four. And what was really difficult for him is that while he had already, he learned to read music very quickly because he was already really good at math and understood numbers. And that was like his area of interest was numbers. And so music, learning the music was no problem for him. But what was difficult for him was learning the technique and learning like when to play softly and when to play sharply and when to play loud and when to play, you know, staccato or, you know, legato. Those different types of techniques were really hard for him because he has a pragmatic language disorder that comes with his autism that just sometimes just makes him not get what it is that you're trying to say, especially if it's something that's very subtle or like a nuance that he doesn't really, isn't able to read between the lines. And so at age 4 and 5, he was diagnosed with autism when he was around 5, it just was difficult for him. And so this particular technique that he was taking and this particular teacher he was taking from, it was so focused on kind of the musicality of playing that I think for him at that time it just wasn't practical. And so in the end we ended up stopping his piano lessons. And so now that he's 10, we've gotten him back engaged with piano, and I'm glad to say that he's doing great. He's just blazing through the curriculum, and really, I mean, he can play Coldplay and do all sorts of really neat stuff, and it's such a great outlet for him just to hear him. Sometimes when I can tell he's angry or frustrated, he will go to the piano and just play, and it's like amazing to see that he's able to do that and really, you know, engage with music in that way. But looking back, the lesson learned is I really wish that we had thought a little bit more about different choices for him in terms of the different piano teachers or different techniques or different methods that we could have kept him engaged with instead of stopping lessons. I really wish that we had gone through the extra step of, you know, finding a different teacher or looking into a different method that wasn't so focused on technique and just kind of, you know, looking for different avenues. I think we just kind of realized he had autism and realized that it maybe wasn't going to be easy for him and just kind of decided, you know, we're going to focus on therapy and OT and speech and some other things. But looking back, I still, you know, kind of think, wow, if we kept him engaged for those 5 years, I wonder where he would be today in terms of the piano. So I think for me, I just wish that looking back that we had spent a little bit of extra time looking into finding the right teacher, because now his teacher, when we went and started looking for teachers, I actually sent out some emails to several different teachers and told them about his differences. And the teacher that engaged back with us said, you know, oh, that's great. I actually have another student who's on the spectrum and I'm making such great progress with her. I've actually been looking to add kids on the spectrum to my studio. And we're like, fabulous. Like, you just couldn't ask for anything more than that. And she is. She's just a great fit for him. Is very patient. Just has a kind of different way of teaching that is exactly what he needs. And so I'm just really thankful that we were able to get him back engaged with piano. So I guess the lesson learned is just both, you know, doing anything that necessary to make sure that your kids have the extra time they need when it comes to music and lessons and instruments, and then also just going the extra mile of looking to find the right teacher and the right technique, the right curriculum, whatever it is, for your child to be able to engage with them learning an instrument, because it really is worth it when you see them, you know, using music as the outlet, you know, that it really should be, and just helps them engage and show emotion. And maybe for my son, showing emotion actually isn't something that's really difficult for him. It is for a lot of kids in the autism spectrum. And I've heard that music can just be like an amazing way of allowing them to kind of like emote, you know. So, but anyway, so that's kind of our experience with music. And I stay tuned because I'm hoping to be able to report more about how the progress that they've made in music in the future. So, but anyway, thank you so much for listening and being engaged today. Sorry if you heard my dog barking a little bit in the background. Hopefully I can edit that out, but if not, I wanted to apologize. And hopefully I'll be able to see you again next week. Thank you so much. Take care.